Hello everyone, I'm Vaishnavi from class 7th and today I have brought a new video and it's not about the question answers of the previous chapter Architectural in Medieval India, but we are going to start a new chapter which is New Kings and Kingdoms of History again. Okay, so it is going to be interesting and it's going to be very fun because it has a lot of topics in this chapter and we are going to discuss some of the big ideas and we are going to discuss some glance look in today's class and we are also going to discuss the introduction today itself. And so we are going to do the three things that I'm noting down like in the previous session only, that we are going to start a new chapter and the big idea, then we are going to study the glance, we are going to study in the glance look the timeline also, and we are also going to study the introduction of this chapter. And after that I'll upload some videos which I will create the playlist where you can see all of those videos in one group only and you can see step by step those videos. So without wasting time sharing my screen in front of you all, hope you can see my screen. And yes, it is New Kings and Kingdoms. And the big idea of this chapter is to emergence of new kingdoms and kings in a particular area. Then we have the Gurjaras, the Pratiharas, the Pallas. The Rashtrakutas, Chauhans, Ghaznavids and Cholas. We are going to discuss all these things in today's session with this timeline that I have on my screen. So let me just on my pointer right now. So here I have my pointer. Just a second. Yes. So the new kings and kingdoms, the big idea is this. And then we have the administration, which contains economy and social and also the political life during the period. I forgot to write the political life over here, but it's the political life too. So let's go on the next screen right now. Yeah. So the learning objectives of this chapter are to learn the types of regional developments, to learn the concept of the new kings and kingdoms, and to learn about the Turkish invaders. Now, these three topics might be looking very small to you, but this chapter is very, very big. And it's interesting too because it has a lot of information about different types of rulers, or we can say the kings and kingdoms. So, let's start with our slide, with the introduction slide, right? So, the early period of medieval Indian history was marked by the scramble of power among the various Indian kingdoms in the north. Now remember, we are talking about the north region, means in the map we talk about over here. So if we talk over here, we see different types of Jammu Kashmir, we see different types of the map in the above north side, right? So in this north side, what we have in the introduction is in the medieval period, when in the Indian history, it was marked for scramble. Means scramble for the power. Means over here in this region, there was a lot of kings and their kingdoms that wanted to power of this region. And so you can see a lot of rivers are also flowing from here. One is Indus, and then we have Chenab, Satluj, Ravi, and we have a lot of rivers, right? And more rivers are there in this yellow region. We'll discuss this point after some time. And it is one of the, like, over here also many kings and kingdoms were there. And we'll discuss why they were there. So, coming to the next topic, which is, it was also a period of political uncertainty caused by the foreign invasions. Caused by the foreign invasions, and we can also say that this period actually brought the like in the medieval Indian history, this period also have the two periods, like early medieval period and the late medieval period, right? In which a lot of changes were also there in the political, social and many things. Yes, so there was an uncertainty that was caused by the foreign invasions, means foreign kingdoms, okay? And then they set a stage for the If we talk about this, set a stage for the later events of Indian history as they evolved. Means when they came to India, when they came over here in the north region, in the south region, in the central region, what they did by means they actually evolved the Indian history together and set it in a particular thing. We can say they set a stage for the later events of the Indian history, right? So over here, we take a look of different things in the next paragraph. It also saw the rise of Cholas in the south. Now, till now, we were talking about the different types of kingdoms in the north, right? So, if we talk about the south and the central region, in the central region, what about them? In the central region and in the south region, first, let's talk about the south. Over here, as you can see, there are Cholas, there are Cheras, and there are Pandyas too. So, in the south, we can see there are three kingdoms, and about these three kingdoms, we have discussed in the sixth class also. Means we have learned this topic about the Cheras, Cholas, and Pandyas in the sixth class too. And so, these three kingdoms come in the south region of India. As they come in the south region of India, also they have different types of case studies over them, right? In the Cholas, we have different case study that we'll learn in further chapter, and that's too far from us right now. We have to study a lot of topics before that topic. So, without wasting time, let's go to the next screen. After the introduction, we are going to do the Tripartite struggle. And then we are going to do the Gurjara Pratiharas, and then the Pallas, Rashtrakutas, and many other things like Turkish empires too. So for today, I'm taking a leave from all of you, and don't forget to like, share, subscribe my video. And also, let's do one more thing that I wanted to do with you all, which is the recap. So in the recap thing, we are going to study different things also. So my recap slide is coming to you all, I hope. So in the recap, we have actually learned in today's session in the introduction or the big idea we have learned, right? And in the introduction, we have learned the different kingdoms in different parts of India. Different kingdoms in different parts of India. Different parts of India. So these all regions, these all kingdoms are being settled in different parts of India, and also there are like some regions which they have three kingdoms, which they have four to five kingdoms, because there is a lot of cultivation there. There is a lot of political and economic sources are there which help them to settle their like community over there, that part. So we have also discussed about the different kingdoms and the different parts of north region also. We have discussed the north region, and also we have discussed the polity uncertainty of foreign invasion. So you can take a like hint as foreign invasions, right? So we have discussed this much today, and also we have discussed about the Cholas in the south. And it is just a brief look at how we'll actually do this chapter. So you can take this video as a short period, which can help you to look the whole glance look over this chapter, right? So we are going to study the Cholas in the south too. So this is a recap, and actually we are going to continue the video in more sessions, and I'll make a playlist as I told you in the first of this video. So till then, I'm taking a leave from you all. But before that, just see the things that you have in front of you. So you can take the screenshot and you can take everything in front of you. So I'm just stop screen sharing, and for today, taking a leave from you all. Thank you everyone, and bye bye.